Welcome back to the computer networking protocol learning. So I'm going to just give you a glimpse of a very important protocol which is there for a long time, which is still ruling the networking world, DHCP, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. It is such a very important protocol that it has revolutionized the way the IP addresses have been assigned. I'll just give you a scenario. Assume that we have about 10 machines in the network. For example, in the network, we have 10 machines. Assigning IP address for it and tracking that assigned IP address through an Excel sheet or through a notepad or through a paper would not be tougher. It would be pretty easier for us to handle. Assume that we have a network now expanded, which is having about 100 machines in the network. Even then, we will have to be a bit smarter. We will have to maintain an Excel sheet properly, and we can assign IP address, and all those things can still happen. But assume that you get a thousands of machines in your network where you cannot really assign addresses without any repetition. You will certainly go for duplication, because managing the addresses would be very difficult, and assigning address statically would be a problem there. So now, I use the word statically here. We have two kinds of assignment of addresses. One is static assignment, another one is dynamic assignment. Static assignment is done by a man, and it can be done for a very minimal network efficiently. When it goes larger, where I do not know how many machines really I have in my network, such a huge network is there in front of me, I really need some protocol, some software to come and help me out, and that's what is called dynamic assignment of IP address. And we have one such protocol called as Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, and that protocol is used very widely to assign IP addresses to the machines in the network automatically without having any intervention of a human. So this is allocated, the IP addresses are allocated automatically without any intervention, and it is done very efficiently, and there is no pain. Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol assigns IP, tracks it, releases the IP back into the pool. So one simple question that we guys can be asked in the interview is, what will happen when you assign IP address statically? In the view, you can tell that what are the disadvantages that you will get when you get IP addresses assigned statically. Number one, we will assign IP address and we will not release it. We will not get that address again released back to the pool where we can use it for someone else. That's a major problem. Assignment of IP address itself is a panic. Tracking IP address is a panic. All these are overcome in our DHCP. So what is DHCP? I already explained to you. DHCP is Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. So DHCP has got four very important packets or signals, you can say. First one is DHCP discover. So let us take a scenario. I am the machine, or I have a laptop, I get into a company, I get into an organization or a network. When I get into a network, I need IP addresses for me to join the network as well as to access the internet and all those things. So when I get into the network, I will start searching for the IP address. So I may have two or one or more DHCP servers. Assuming that we have two DHCP servers like this scenario, I have one client here, I am the client, I have two DHCP servers here. Now I will start searching for the DHCP first. So that is called DHCP discover. So we need to understand what is DHCP discover. So DHCP discover is a packet which will be used by a host when it wishes to join a network. The moment I come into the network, I need to send the DHCP discover. Now this client, whichever has sent the DHCP discover, will be observed by the DHCP servers. And when I have two DHCP servers available with me, I'll start receiving the packet, and both the DHCP servers will try to respect the DHCP discover request that has been sent by the client. So what will happen now, you can see this picture. I am the client here, the client is here, the client sends DHCP discover here, DHCP discover here. We have two servers here, both are DHCP servers. Now this server will also respect you, this server will also respect you. So we will get DHCP offer packet back. DHCP offer will come to you back. Now what will happen with this DHCP offer? This DHCP offer will tell you the details of the IP address that can be offered, how long the IP address can be held back by the client, that detail. All these will be available in the DHCP offer. Now what will happen? I get two offers, out of which only one I can accept. Now see that here, I try to accept only one of the offers, that is this server, the right hand side server which I am moving now, is selected. So the DHCP request will now be sent only to the server you can see the real. I'll explain you this way. The client can choose to accept any of the IP addresses offered by these two DHCP servers, which means it can accept A's offer or B's offer. So now what will happen? I need to just make sure that I respect one of these offers, and I need to really deny one of those offers which I do not want, because that address can be used for something else. Now see that here, I now respond to this by saying my interest, and immediately the acknowledgement will be given by the selected server, which means selected server will be responding back with a reply. Now this server, what will happen, this is not selected server, it will take that IP addresses whatever it has assigned, and it will certainly put it back in the pool of available IP addresses. So one should try to understand this concept before going further. Now one should also understand that you can see that from this picture, the DHCP request packet has been sent to both the servers. This server also has got the packet, this server also has got the packet. But in the reply packet, it will say that which out of these two offers this guy is going to take. So on understanding that DHCP request packet, this server will understand that his offer is not respected. So we need to see about rest of the packets, which are DHCP acknowledgement. The DHCP acknowledgement is something which is coming from the server whose offer has been accepted by the client. Now the IP address is assigned, we have taken the IP address from the server, the server is also informed that I am interested in your IP address, everything is done. The process is simple: DHCP discover packet goes out, DHCP offer packet comes in, one of those offers will be respected, IP address will be assigned. Is that over there? No, it is not over, we have more things there. They are to be tracked right now. Now, I will be allocated with the IP address for a lease period. So for example, I'll have a lease period of about 1 hour per IP address. So now, here it will be pretty simple. I have two timers available. First timer is called T1, second timer is called T2. The timer 1 is called renewal timer, timer 2 is called rebinding timer. Timer 1 will be set to 50% of the total lease period. So what will happen, if lease is 1 hour, 30 minutes will be the value set to timer 1. Now T2 will be set to 87.5% of the lease period. Now what will happen, when the T1 expires, which means 50% of the time frame expires, the renewal process will start again. The DHCP request will go again, and then the same process whatever I explained you some time back will happen again. Now if the IP address is assigned again back to the same client, the T2 period will remain consistent. Otherwise, it will keep moving, and by the time we complete our process, it's all released properly. So the IP address will be released from there. This is the work of DHCP. Now, packet format, and that's what I'm showing you right in front of you. This DHCP packet format has got many columns, including code, hardware type, length, number of hops, etc. Code. What is the code? The code will tell you if it is a DHCP request or a reply. Hardware type. Hardware type will tell you what kind of hardware are we using. Normally we will use Ethernet. A length. What is the length of the hardware that we are using? I mean, length is the hardware address. What is the length of the hardware address that we are using here? Then hops. Number of hops that I need to really move on to connect into the DHCP server. Transaction ID. Every transaction will have a random number generated, and that number will be referred as the transaction ID. Seconds. How many seconds has been elapsed from the time we started the process of renewal or request? Client IP address, we know what it is. Your IP address is the request of the address issued by the DHCP server to the client, which means after I request you an address, you are assigning me an address, so you will call it your IP address. Server IP address, we know what it is. Router IP address, we know what it is. Client hardware address, we know the MAC address of the client. Server name, mostly optional, and many of us do not use it. Boot file name. Name of the file containing the boot image for BootP client. Let's not worry about this BootP protocol right now. We have a separate work for it. We will look into it later. Options is an optional field that we will see later. Now, we have some interesting questions for you. How to find IP address of a PC which has a Windows OS installed? Simple, ipconfig is the command. How to find IP address of a Linux machine? ifconfig-a. How do we release an IP address from Windows PC? You can plug the cable out or switch off the wireless connection. That's one way of doing it. But with DHCP, if you want to really do it, ipconfig/release. Similarly, how do you renew it? ipconfig/renew. I hope this was interesting, and we will meet you again with one more interesting protocol in the next session. Thank you very much. You guys can try this out in your machine, but you will get the IP address again allocated properly if you are connected to a Wi-Fi network or in a local network, or in the LAN. Don't worry, you can try the release and renew, and it is not going to hurt you. Thank you very much. I'll see you again in the next session. Thanks.